Hello everyone, Ashley McAfee here for English 115 Public Speaking. What has roots but no leaves? That's right, those pearls of yours, teeth. Teeth come in all different shapes, sizes, and shades, but the way to care for them is pretty universal. I have an oral health care regimen that can prevent the most prevalent disease in the nation, according to the CDC, dental caries. In light of working in dentistry the past 3 years, I know everyone's preference is different. Considering that, I've incorporated many techniques to get the job done for everyone's needs. Now let's get into the instruments, as we say in dentistry, needed to make the sweet music of prevention for your oral health care. First, you want to make sure you have all the components to make this possible. The first item is going to be floss. The second set of items are going to be your toothbrush and your toothpaste. The third will be your antiseptic mouthwash. The fourth thing you're going to need is patience to get this thing adequately done the right way. Now, the variant of items is strictly your preference. The market is so huge for every item. Please choose something suitable for you, but please choose something to make this a good oral healthcare regimen. With floss, we have your traditional floss, the string floss. Then we have a floss pick. Some people think that's more, you know, convenient. And then for our geriatric patients or older patients, we usually recommend a pressurized water mechanism, aka a water flosser. It actually pushes the water in between the teeth to dislodge any debris or bacteria. As far as your toothbrush, you can use a manual toothbrush or an electric toothbrush. Either or will get the job done. As far as your antiseptic mouthwash, they come in different flavors and variants. Please choose one suitable for you. With your patients, I do not recommend you choose on that area. Please bring your patients with any technique you will be using. Now that we have all the instruments to make the sweet music, let's get into it. We do not want to brush the debris and bacteria into our gums. So first we will actually use the floss to dislodge any remnants of bacteria, debris, or food from the interproximal in between areas of our teeth. It is important to use an effective flossing method when you do floss. The first thing when you do floss, you're going to take at least an arm length of floss if you're using your string floss to make sure that you're not pushing your bacteria from tooth to tooth when you are flossing. When you floss, you are going to go where your teeth meet, which are your contacts, push all the way through to your gum line. Once you get to your gum line, you're going to do a wave-like motion around your gum line. After you do that, you're going to also hug the opposing tooth, making sure any plaque or anything that's in between those two teeth are being taken out. Please remember to not do a sawing motion is a big misconception that can also damage your gums and actually create a pathway for bacteria. Now look at you making music of cleanliness. Now let's get into the most important part, brushing. The third step is to brush the remaining debris, food, or plaque of bacteria away from your teeth structure and also the bacteria off of your tongue. You're going to take your manual or electric toothbrush and you're going to angle it at a 45 degree angle. Before doing so, definitely put your toothpaste on your toothbrush head. Once you angle your toothbrush at a 45 degree angle, you're going to go in a circular motion, getting each area of your tooth. You will be doing every quadrant, 1, 2, 3, 4, for 30 seconds each. When you are brushing your teeth with that circular motion, if you do have an electric toothbrush, you do not need to do a circular motion. That can cause abrasion, which means you're pressing too hard on your teeth. We'll get into the details of that later. You should brush your teeth for no less than 2 minutes, the time it takes for you to sing the happy birthday song twice. Make sure after you're done brushing your teeth, you stick out your tongue and brush the bacteria off your tongue where the bacteria has been harboring all day. They also have tongue scrapers to help you with that area. Important things to remember when brushing, do not brush too hard because it can cause gum recession, which can in turn make your teeth actually sensitive. In doing so, it makes it more susceptible to tooth decay later down the road. And like I said, making sure you get every tooth surface, even if you have to do 15 seconds on the outer area and 15 seconds on the inner area, making sure you hit everything. Now that we've cleaned to the best of our ability, let's make a meaningful exit to this oral healthcare regimen with rinsing. The fourth step is to rinse with the antiseptic mouthwash. You're going to take at least a quarter cup of that mouthwash of your preference and rinse for 45 seconds. The mouthwash gets into places that your toothbrush and your floss cannot get into. Mouthwash is the most overlooked step in your oral healthcare regimen. According to the Listerine website, it cleans more than 25% of your mouth than the traditional techniques I've listed in this demonstration. It comes in different flavors and variants. If you cannot handle the traditional alcohol mouthwash, they come in, you know, organic and other things that are on the market. Please note that something is definitely better than nothing. So please choose something that's going to work for you and actually get the job done. Throughout the process, please do not forget your patience, because that is key in making the sweet song of a good oral hygiene. The steps in making your healthcare sound and sufficient are: first, having the right components or instruments. Second, dislodging food and debris with your floss. Third, brushing with your toothbrush and your toothpaste the remaining debris and bacteria from your tongue also. And then finally, rinsing with your mouthwash. I know this is better, you know, said than done. So I feel as though if I demonstrate it for you guys, you can get a better look at how things are supposed to be done. Here goes my floss, about arm length. Boom, you take this, you go to your teeth, contact where they meet. Wah-ah. You saw that wave-like motion, went up to my gum line, made sure I dislodged anything. You're going to take your toothbrush and your toothpaste, bop, boop. You're going to take your mannequin, teeth. You're going to brush in that circular motion, 45 degree angle. Like I said, if you have an electronic toothbrush like so, please do not push. You see it turns red. That means you're pushing too hard and you can damage your teeth. Please be mindful, if this had a tongue, you would stick out your tongue, brush it, brush that bacteria, or scrape it off with the tongue scraper. That's what you would do in that aspect. And then you will take your mouth rinse and rinse for 45 seconds and spit out. I hope this was very informational for you guys to making an oral healthcare regimen sound and sufficient. Please be careful in making it done the right way. Thank you.